Before we get into the secret world of these mysterious tunnels under the city of Paris, we should probably explain to those of you who don't know what the catacombs actually are. And before you get carried away with your imagination, these are not, as it has been depicted in cinema, with hordes of ravenous zombies living down there. According to Les Catacombes de Paris website, the reason these holes in the ground got started was because in the 18th century Paris had a major problem on its hands. The issue was the fact that the cemeteries were too full and a place was needed to put a lot of dead bodies, and we're talking about millions. Stuck with this morbid task, the Parisian authorities chose a site called the Tumisois Quarries. Those quarries were no longer in use, having been dug in the 15th century and onwards, but abandoned sometime later. These underground tunnels stretched for 800 hectares under the city of Paris. The job at hand was called bone transfer, and the man responsible for emptying the cemeteries and moving the remains of once moving, laughing, eating, procreating, and dying Parisians was a guy called Charles Axel Guillemot. With his department, he started the moving house process in 1785, and the excavation of bones was done from the biggest cemetery in Paris at the time, called the Saints Innocent Cemetery. It had been closed for 5 years prior, as there was literally no space for any more dead people. It had been taking corpses by that time for 10 centuries, which is a lot of bones, and no room at the Dead Man's Inn scenario was not just a French problem. If you read Bill Bryson's book At Home, A Short History of Private Life, you can read that France's neighbor Great Britain was having its own problems with getting rid of the dead. Back to France. This operation of bone transfer was done under a cloak of darkness, lest people get offended by someone manhandling their deceased family members' bits and pieces. The bones were taken down to the quarries and put into what were called galleries. Work stopped for a while, and upstairs some of the French were busy revolting, and quite a lot were dying, making the burial situation even worse. Following the revolution, work commenced, and smaller cemeteries around Paris had their bones taken from them. While the site was officially called the Paris Municipal Ossuary, it began to take on mythical proportions and was informally called the Catacombs, after the tunnels under the ancient city of Rome. So there we have it, an abridged version at least. Paris needed a place for bones because the cemeteries were busting at the seams, and that's why those underground tunnels were made. As you can imagine, such a place was kinda spooky for the French, and back then people weren't always opposed to stories of the dead rising and other superstitious beliefs. If you get spooked by graveyards now, imagine what the average Parisian thought back then of a place where millions of the dead were buried, not all with content souls. In fact, it's said the catacombs hold around 7 million people. You might even call it the City of the Dead, so it's no wonder that filmmakers have chosen it as a spot for horror flicks. Next time you're in Paris, you should take your Ouija board down there, but remember not to say, "Is anybody here?" because the spirits probably won't understand you. Instead, say, "Y a-t-il quelqu'un ici?" It might have been scary, but after 1809, when the place was open to the public, it attracted a lot of visitors from France and abroad. It even got more visitors when well-known people were sent to live for eternity down there, including once President of France Napoleon III, related to the bellicose Napoleon you all know well. At times, the hordes of visitors got too much for the authorities, and they limited entrance or just closed the place to the public for months on end. These days, you can go down there any time of the year, and it's said annually about 550,000 people do just that. Okay, so that's the history. What about the mystery and intrigue? Well, one would think that an underground place of that size would have an underground society. That it did, and we're told on August 23, 2004, cops went down there and had quite the surprise finding a cinema. We must mention here that some parts of the catacombs are closed off from the public, but it seems some people get past the barriers. This is what Gizmodo tells us about this discovery. They found 3,000 square feet of subterranean galleries strung with lights, wired for phones, live with pirated electricity. The officers uncovered a bar, a lounge, workshop, dining corner, and small screening area. When they found a metal container with fat and wires in it, they thought they'd come across a bomb and that something very ominous was going on down in these holes. But the bomb squad said what they found was merely a couscous maker. Who were these people? The cops didn't know, and when they returned a few days later with more authorities, they found most of the equipment gone and a letter left for them reading "Ne cherchez pas," meaning "Don't search." That kind of message obviously caused a friction of panic in the police, as saying "don't search" was what someone with bad intent might say. Soon the world's media was speculating. Was there an underground movement in Paris? It wouldn't be the first time Parisians had machinated to attack the powers that be. This was serious given that many of the closed tunnels could be home to anything, and there was supposed to be about 155 miles of passageways in total. But nothing sinister was going on, and later a group responsible for the underground cinema said, "We're the counterpoint to an era where everything is slow and complicated." It was discovered that the group called themselves the Mexican Consolidated Drilling Authority. That's the English translation. This was a serious outfit, given they'd stolen electricity to power their cinema, and got all that stuff down there without anyone seeing. But others have been fascinated by the catacombs for years, and these folks are often called cataphiles. Who wouldn't be fascinated by a place where the Phantom of the Opera hid and where millions of dead rest? But many real-life things have happened down there that caused people to be intrigued. A group known as the Communards, not the 80s British pop duo, killed a bunch of French monarchists in the tunnels. The French resistance hid in them, while the Nazis had a bunker down in the catacombs. More recently, Airbnb paid a whopping $300,000 to rent some parts of the tunnels for the night. What's more interesting, especially to cataphiles, is that there are many, many secret entrances to the catacombs. You might find a doorway to this underground world of the dead in bar cellars, subway tunnels, and better still, in church crypts. Not surprisingly, sometimes these doors get found and people go down there to explore. And let's face it, you're not a teenager if you don't enjoy exploring places you probably shouldn't go. Well, perhaps modern teens do most of their exploration in the digital realm and in games, but in the past, the best thing about being young was sneaking into places and quite often getting in trouble. Could there be any place in the world better to sneak into for a bunch of teens than the Paris catacombs? Well, that happened in 2017, but as you might expect, it didn't go too well for the itinerant teens. Two boys, aged 16 and 17, got lost down there with the dead and were only eventually pulled out 3 days later, both with a mild case of hypothermia. 3 days underground in the cold, walking around the tunnels with no food and mostly in darkness takes sneaking into places another level. Still, they have a better story to tell than "I completed level 5. Okay, so it might just be a little irresponsible of us to promote this kind of adventure. We say this because someone died down there in 2016. The person didn't die from cold or being lost, though. He died of a heart attack when he was partying hard down there. One thing you should know about the catacombs is they have been a top spot for Parisian people who like to party. You could call these events the quintessential underground party. The French media says a bunch of people took down some music, along with a lot of booze and some substances not legal in the living world. Things turned awry when a 45-year-old man's heart had seen too much partying. There are other reports of people going missing down there. In 2011, 5 people went down drunk, but it was a prank, and 2 ran away to leave the others. But they didn't get out and spent 2 days wandering around. In other cases, artists have gone to make films and take pictures, some of them even with an erotic angle. One of the people who controls how many people go down there says every week people ask him if they can visit and do something weird or wonderful. Obviously, we say no, this is a sacred place, which houses the remains of 6 million Parisians. "We only allow serious or scientific documentaries," he said to the French media. He says there's a growing problem with what are called naked explorers, and many of them apparently come all the way from the USA. We are told that the modus operandi often is for the people to go down there and pretend they're just tourists, but then they leave lots of equipment and return later. But for the locals, they're still what you might call an underground cult that visits the catacombs and discusses art, the end of the world, or just take a swim where pools of water can be found, free from the hustle and bustle of the Parisian streets and the pretension of the cafe culture. Some French folks just like to get down with the dead and leave the rest of the world behind. But as you might expect, such a good hiding place is also attractive to those people inclined to criminality. In 2017, there was a case which involved some thieves drilling through walls to get to some rather special vintage wine that was secretly kept underground. That wine was said to be worth over $280,000. That's not a bad score for a place that usually keeps just a bunch of old bones and dusty skulls. Would you go down in these catacombs? Do you think you'd be up for being a cataphile? Also, be sure to check out our other video, "American Things Europeans Find Weird." Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. We'll see you next time.